like take us through that whole first over, how the way you set Steve Smith up and the wicket and the celebration and just that whole over basically.
Look, first things first, I mean, I'm so happy that we are playing Test cricket again. It's been a long time and I didn't imagine at some stage we will be playing Test cricket because of what's happening around. And for me being extremely mad about the sport and doing a lot of work even during the lockdown, it felt so refreshing to go out there and have a bowl. I mean, the feeling was great. Ping ball test and all that. All the new thing about ping ball, and I haven't taken a picture of ping ball and all that. Just felt amazing to go out there and play. I felt like I was making my debut all over again. So I really enjoyed my bowl. With regards to the wicket of Steve Smith, obviously it's a big wicket. Bats, you know how much time he bats. That runs huge. So at the context of the game where it was placed, I felt it was a very important wicket. So I enjoyed it. Obviously, I guess I'm really happy to enjoy it.
Hi, Ashwin. It's just a question. How important is the trajectory when you bowl in Australia?
Look, I think every spinner is different, and I think sometimes things can get blown out of context in terms of how purchase is trade and whatnot. Even in this test match, and I, we both bowl very differently. We are different bowlers and successful in our own ways. So for me, it's not so much about the trajectory or anything. It's about trying and changing and making it difficult for the batsman to be able to defend and also score at the same time. And sometimes when you're playing for bowlers, actually above where my trade is just to hold one end up and rotate the fast bowlers at the other end. I also go for wickets if I do get enough positions or early wickets. So for me, it becomes extremely important to keep going and making it as difficult as possible for batsmen to defend.
Hi, wanted to ask you, like, among all your performances, where would you rate this performance of yours in terms of your overseas performances? Is it right at the top?
Look, in the last 2 years, if people might not not reflect upon a couple of not so great situations or matches, if I may call so. I've pretty much had decent outings every time I've gone on to play abroad in the last 18 months or so, yes. Things can get blown out of context. And I have put those things in the shelf and it's in the backyard. As far as I'm concerned, I've learned from there. I really want to enjoy my trade and I want to, have all the fun that I possibly can. So for me, it's not... I don't want to sit back now and think whether that's the best or not. There is an innings to go and I'm looking forward to all the entire test series. It's a great opportunity for me to be able to play the game.
You were hardly required to bowl in Calcutta last year. So considering this was your first real long spell with the pink ball, and Shane Warne yesterday reiterated the need to possibly try out pink ball even in day test matches. How has your experience been and do you think it's an experiment worth trying out?
I still think the pink ball is in its is at a very nascent stage of where test cricket should head forward, but I'm sure it is very exciting for a lot of people watching the game. Personally, the one player didn't know was a different sort of pink ball, and this one's a different one. This is Cooper and that one's HD. So I think Adelaide has hosted the maximum number of day-night tests, if I'm not wrong, in terms of stats, and they're 5 years into the pink ball test arena. So I think we've got a lot of things going for them in terms of how the ball works, how the pitches and how the lights are, etc. So I would say that it's at a very nascent stage and we trying way too many things in terms of pushing players to a certain brim. I'm not really sure, but I think there is a place for the pink ball test, surely.
Hi, Ash. My question is, the decision to send Jasprit Bumrah as the night watchman, could you please elaborate on that? I mean, did his performance in the warm-up match influence you have enough confidence in his batting, Jasprit?
Look, firstly, I would like to say that Jasprit is an extremely... competitive cricketer. He really likes to take a battle on, and ever since he's come on to test cricket. His bowling is there to see for everyone. See for himself. But he's earnest effort in terms of how much he bats and how much he's improved his eye. There have been times when he's walked in and you know the team has changed voice, changed moves and all that. But now, from being well, he's actually made a 50 and he looks at home when he's defending also. So it was a no-brainer as far as the team was concerned. And I thought even in that little phase that he batted, he infused a lot of confidence.
Yeah. Hi, Ashwin. Ashwin, did you guys, when you guys took the field in the morning, do you guys think 244 was a good enough total? And in terms of setting a target, what do you think would be an ideal total for you guys?
Look, going by what happened last time at Adelaide, we get to get, you know, better to bat as the test match goes on. And in fact, we felt like it played best for the batters on day five the last time. So when we went into the match, we felt like it was a very similar situation we were in. Maybe the matting of grass on the pickup is a little thicker than what it was last year. But if we thought we were right in the game, the sort of, I think we made 2 last time, we made about 5 or 6 run short this time. So we knew we were in with the contest and thought we repeated bowling performance that was probably one much better than the last time.
There's always a talk about following the spinners who have been successful in conditions in like England or Australia, like a Nathan Lyon or a Moeen Ali. How much do you take that into consideration while preparing for an overseas tour?
Look, it's sometimes I feel these sort of comparisons and the way we look at things are very skewed. Nobody asks batsmen to go and watch how Steve Smith bats and replicate that all the time when we tour Australia. Nobody does that to Alistair Cook or Joe Root the way they play, because I think we are all aware that everybody skins a cat very, very differently. So you can learn. There is no stoppage or ending to what you learn from people. You can always learn all the finer things, how they go about their business, how they set their field, the passage of play. I've always maintained this, especially when you travel and you play abroad away from India, the passages of play need to go your way as a spinner, because you're doing a twin job and not necessarily against, you're doing it against the conditions. So as far as I'm concerned, I keep watching and see if I can learn, also prepare thoroughly to the batsman and, you know, put in the earnest effort, and that's all one can do. And how people perceive it and how they compare it is for them to do. You guys do a job, I'm doing mine.
Talava, from outside it looks like this Labuschagne looks from outside almost similar to Steve Smith the way he bats. Does he bat similarly against spin also? What's your when you bowl to Labuschagne, does it feel like you're bowling to Steve Smith? And secondly, your batting was very crisp yesterday. And you had said in a recent interview with Harsha at Cricbuzz that the mistake you had made a year and a half or something, that you were defending too much rather than trusting your attack. Have you firmed up that mind and that you're going to attack more? Is that the way to go?
No, look, I want to play cricket from inside, and I somewhere felt like I might have not had the kind of joy walking out there and playing it for a while, and it's quite natural. It does lower a bit of time. And for me to bring about that joy, I thought it's not the greatest of times, but my reflection sitting down in the lockdown and reflecting on cricket and enjoying watching cricket again is something that I was able to bring back. I thought I lost for a big amount of time. And to answer your question about Steven Smith, I think he idolizes after Steven Smith. So he actually does so many things like what Steven Smith does that you probably are thinking that Steven Smith is actually coffee love, okay? But I think there's definitely a difference in the way, but not necessarily an identity copy or anything. It's the mannerism that Steven Smith does tries to replicate. It's only natural. I mean, the future, but you would want to be a bad piece, because you idolize and you go against someone, and I think he's not ideal when he's setting.
Thank you, Josh. For time now, we'll have to end this. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.